Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Weekly Recap for Escape from Tarkov. My name is Jackson Brett, and now your Tarkov informer, Brett 7.
Hello friends, Brett 7 here. This week was a busy and rough week for the devs. Busy because of the new patch that's going to be released very soon, so the guys are preparing new content, fixing stuff, smashing bugs and some stuff like that. Rough because of the netcoding issue. I will talk about it later in this video, but now let's first cover the EFT news for those of you who only want to see what's new, what has or will change. Nevertheless, the netcode issue, it's a very important matter, so watching the video till the end is what I recommend you should do. First news for today's video has to do with the partnership between BSG and Valdai. It's the introduction of the 1PN138 night vision scope, which is very well welcomed as it adds more variety to the game. Next on our news board, we have the patch announcement. This is a very interesting patch. It adds some new features and items and struggle to fix a lot of stuff. Let's take a more in-depth look at it. Then we will talk about the netcode and some other news I could gather this week. First, what we need to know is that there's going to be no wipe. For some of us, disappointing because once you did your missions and found your keys, there is nothing else to do except PvP and more PvP. For some others, a relief because they can keep their gear for a while longer. The devs will add several new features and items to the game with the coming of the new patch. A new helmet, the one you see right now, the 6P47, a very ugly looking night scope, the N-SPAM, the XC1 flashlight we have seen in previous recaps, and another Glock flashlight, the GL21 with laser designator block, the Hera tactical grip and pistol grip, a new muzzle brake called VP09 or 09. Added mechanics for weapons mod exception and installation prevention. To be honest, I don't know what the devs mean with this. I guess someone will explain what this is in the comments, or we will just have to wait. And two new maps, the Azure Coast Health Resort and the Shoreline Location. After the release, according to the patch notes, the devs will add the new Glock with 30 separate mods and the new trader, the mechanic. The Glock looks amazing, the guys did an awesome job creating it. It has a lot of attachments, as you can see, extended mags, drum mags, flashlights, suppressors, different colors and more. It will be a pleasure customizing it. Playing with it against that Fort Armor, I don't know what to say. There are tons of gear out there we don't use because they're useless against Fort. Sad. Apart from that, the boys did some stuff to improve the server performance and the netcode. It will be nice here to have some more details, like what exactly you guys did. This way, it will make it more credible, and we will understand a bit more on what are you guys working at, what got improved, what was bad, and so on. Not just two empty phrases to shut people's mouths. The other stuff are changes and fixes. Pause the video if you want to read them all. I have pointed the ones I saw interesting. The ones I look forward to test are the Alt plus click option to drag items on top of your character, and the other one related to the stash and the inventory. Now let's also talk about the netcode problem the game has, because it's important and I believe every player should be informed before he buys the game or before jumping in another raid alone or with his friends. As expected, the problem with the bad netcode exploded this week with the releasing of the netcode analysis made by Bell Nonsense. Link is in the description. In the video, he shows how bad the netcode is compared to other games. Obviously, we all knew about that, but now we got the proof. It's like official now. The devs immediately reacted to this matter and posted some info on social media, even at the beginning of the patch notes, in order to chill us down a bit. On Reddit, the crowd went crazy over this news, and unfortunately, Nikita had a bad moment trying to defend something that's obviously incorrect. Not going to talk about it too much, just leaving it here so that you guys can read it, but I recommend the devs to act more professional when they talk about stuff like this with the crowd, with us. Some of the players are skilled engineers, programmers, network nerds who cannot be fooled with simple, non-professional answers. And the other majority has common sense. We expect more professionalism here, guys. I went to YouTube to search for some more info related to this netcode thing and found some stuff already, but also clickbait titles. Saw a content creator complaining about performance and netcode and explaining to his subscribers why he gave up on doing streams with EFT content, because of the netcode, of course. Although I somehow got rid of the packets in zero issue by switching to IP version 4, I cannot play more than 2-3 rounds because of the lag and network issues. And of course, because the game has nothing more to offer to me. Got gear, I got my keys, I got my missions done, I am waiting for that new wipe, for the new content. But my friends are still playing a lot. They have a lot of fun in killing people. I am more that explorer type of player. I don't know, are there more of you like me out there? Do you also miss new content? Anyways, the link with the netcode video and the other info I could gather is in the description. I recommend you to check it out first, then think about it, and then start commenting on platforms, on forums, on social media. If you are watching this video, then you already are part of the EFT community and your opinion matters. Write intelligent comments, you are an intelligent gamer and the world expects that from you. I am a bit skeptical about seeing the netcode problem being solved in a short amount of time, but then I remember saying something similar about DayZ and those huge lag problems. Never thought that I would have more than 100 FPS in that game, but somehow the devs made it possible. So let's have faith, guys. We are at the bottom of the pit right now. We cannot go somewhere else than up. Although they're small and inexperienced, although they sometimes make unfortunate comments, these devs care about the community and will try to fix the bad netcode. Nevertheless, we need to bring such problems forward and show that we don't want to play like this anymore. Even in a beta phase, this is not acceptable. They need to do it better, we need to positively criticize them, and if they hear us, then it's a win-win situation for all of us. Last news I have for you guys are some bits I found on the web. First, some news regarded to the lags meta. Apparently there will be some sort of protection slash armor in the future. Thank God if that is true, because every time I died by being shot in the legs, I imagined myself like this. Second, gear presets will be purchasable in the future. That wraps our video up. Thank you for watching my content. Patrons, thank you for the awesome support one more week. Philip, Caesar, CFX Squad, Bam Bam, Jim, Dr. Bloom, Nico, and Joel. Thank you guys for the awesome support. The message I have for you this week is actually a video I saw yesterday. You will find it in the description as well. It's about understanding that too much gaming can be addictive and we should all focus on other things than this. Real life is more important, so go to school, listen to your parents, spend time with your friends and keep gaming under control. Don't exchange your life for something that doesn't really exist. Be wise, gaming is not a way of life. No, it's not. Watch the video and then come back and write a comment. Don't ignore it, otherwise you will regret it in a few years. Red 7 out. Peace.